Good morning, everybody. We're just waiting for people to hop on. Welcome to Barre this morning. I'm Mel, and I'll be taking you through some Barre workout for today. Hope you have fun. So we'll just keep this video on to have people jump in and get ready, and then we'll start in a few minutes. I think we've got about 2 minutes. Good morning, Terry. All right, I tried something different with my audio this morning, so just a thumbs up if you all can hear me. All right. I'm gonna turn on my music and see. All right. Let's get started. So just like any of our other Barre classes today, you'll need a mat, and you'll also need a chair for your Barre to assist you with, and then also some light dumbbells. If you don't have light dumbbells this morning, that is okay. Anything with light resistance can be used as well, or just your arm weight is perfect to work on the mobility of your arms. All right. So with that, we're going to start our warm-up. You want to have at least an arm's distance from your Barre. Give yourself space to move side to side, and then kick front and back. Or two fronts, I mean. All right. Okay, so with that said, who else? Hello, Sharon. Okay, I'm going to start my music, and let's begin. Thank you. flexors here. Push your knees out. All right, arms come wide. Pulse down, two, three. Now reach up, toe feet, and drop. Nice little warm up. Arms down. Punch up. All right, four counts down. Four, two, three. Press four, three, two. One more set. Four, three. Woo! All right, single time till the music ends. Down, up, down, up. Couple more. Four, three, two, and one. Bring it all the way up. Tip forward from the hip. Bend the knees and roll up slowly. Four, three, two, and one. All right, heart rate's up. Legs are definitely warm. We're gonna focus on the upper body. Grab your dumbbells. All right, dumbbells. So a nice little march to find the rhythm here. Hold, take your left leg back, palms face to the front. You're gonna do a letter V, all right? Your arms are open up to the diagonal or to the corners of the room with your right leg leading to the front. Now single time. We go up and down. Your arms just lift right at that shoulder level. Keep your hips square by tucking in that tailbone. Congo, up and back, up and back. Let's go, back. So we're moving a little bit faster. Use the stabilizing muscles so you don't move the whole entire body. Pulse it up. Up for two, back for two. Up for two, back for two. Keep going. Up for two. Last one here. Hold and march in place. All right, nice little march to just give the legs and the body a quick recovery. Round the shoulders up, back, and down. And we switch sides. Right leg back. Letter V this time. So we reset. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Single time. Up, down, up, down. So you're pulling away the resistance from the center. Focusing on the shoulders, the front of the shoulders. Combo, front and back, front and back. So moving at a faster speed. Definitely picks up that heart rate. Pulse, pulse, two times. Up for two, back for two. Up for two, back for two. Come on. One more here. March in place. Roll the shoulders up, back, and down. Sink down onto the hips. And we move to upper body, round two. Okay? So while we're waiting for the next music, go ahead, open the toes out and rotate from the hips. Soften the knees and tuck your tailbone in. Round the shoulders up, back, and down. All right, palms face to the front, right arm goes overhead, and down. Left arm goes overhead, let's go. Right, left. One more each side. Last one. Now both arms go up. Close and open. We're going to start our overhead series. Now if you want more, you can lift your heels. Hold out, press and drop. Press and drop. Press up. All right, isolation. Watch my arms, right side. Right, press. Left, press, hold. You guys ready to join me? Right side. Out, press, hold. Do that again, slow. Out, press, left, press. Same move, a little bit faster. Right, left, continuous, let's go, right. Or, press, left, right, left. Let's go, right, left, right, left. Couple more, right. Now hold it up, elbows down. Squeeze it up. Squeeze it up till the next music, come on. Four, three, two, one. Bring it all the way down, right by your side. Heels down, straighten your legs. Roll the shoulders up, back, and down. All right. This time, our legs can be turned out if you wish, or they can be parallel. But we're gonna focus on the back. So we're gonna tip from the hip. You can be in a diamond shape or parallel. Let the arms hang in front, forearms and dumbbells facing each other. Tuck the chin, take your right arm out.
Yourself forward and hands come by the hips. We're gonna focus on
rows, your belt and your back, your pulling movement. Okay. If you want more, lift the leg at the back. Push off that big toe behind you. Squeeze the butt. Bend the knee, then lift up. Add a pulse. Three, two, up and down. Three, two, up and down. Three, two, up and down. Three, two, up. Hold it here. Front brace, down. So you're coming into a lunge and a static front brace. A static lunge and a single front brace here. Come on, front of the shoulders. Up. Nice and easy. Holding that squat while moving the upper body. All right, back to your rows. Up and down. Up and down. All right, a triple pulse row. Let's go. Three, two, one, pull up. Three, two, one, pull up. Try not to open your shoulders. Keep your shoulders square. And hold. Roll the shoulders up, back, and down. See somebody writing. See something different? All right. I thought you guys couldn't hear me. I saw a long writing. So we're just going to change to the other arm. All right. Big inhale to stretch the back. Exhale, release. Let's move on to the other arm, the other leg. So this time, your right leg steps back. We're going to focus on isolating your left glute. Weight is onto that front heel. Pitch forward from the hip, core engage. Single row. Up and down. Up and down. So again, shoulders and hips stay square. We're not going to open up so you don't compromise your back. Again, if you want more, lift. Again, squeezing the glutes. Pulling the elbows to the back of the room. You guys remember the combo? We're going to repeat that, all right? Triple pull, pulse, then a lift. Three, two, one, up, drop. Three, two, one, up, drop. Three, two, one, up, drop. Four more times. Woo! Two more, then we'll do static lunges. Last one. All good. Back of the arms. Hold it here. Front raise. So 2-2 count. Up. Two. In that static lunge or isolating lunge, your knee is in line with the ankle. If you need assistance, you can use your chair. Alright? Couple more. Away. And we're going to focus down on that lower body. finding the rhythm, and in. Two more slow, and we're gonna speed it up, all right? Two more slow. So we got plenty of time to know what we're doing. Last one slow. And then we speed it up just a little bit, one for one. One, two, three, together. One, two, three, together. You can lift the heels if you want when you step together, or keep the heels down. But if you want, you can use your own workout or your own tempo. One more here. Oh, hold. Double pulse. Double pulse. Oh, you didn't see that coming, right? Double pulse out, double pulse in. Hold. Bring the arms and the hands behind your head, or by your temples. Side bend. Side bend, come on. Crunch the obliques. Till that music ends, just enough for eight, or a little bit more. Three, two, one. Bring over the head, bend towards the left side, push the ribs away from your body. We're gonna turn five on this time. So turn your chair or your bar. All right, left side, slow. Step out, turn in. Step out, together. So we did eight slow, so that we can find the rhythm of the other side. Sometimes we're stronger in one side versus the other. And a non-dominant side takes more time to connect. Four more slow on this side, just for your muscles and mind. Out, in, two more. Last one. All right, I think we speed it up. Out, turn, out, and in. Out.
Here we go. Pulse. Two.
Ronde jump with a pulse. Did I say two more sets? I'm questioning that, but let's go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, yeah. Set 4, that's definitely when you question everything. 4, 3, 2, all over the head, arrowless legs. Tip from the hip forward, fold. Bend the knees, hands on thighs, and slowly roll up. Stack one vertebrae on top of each other. Take your left leg, bring the knees together, push the knees out. And if you want more, tip forward from the hip for a modified dancer's pose. Switch sides, take the other leg, knees come together. If you want more for your hip flexors or quads, tip from the hip. Alright, okay, so after your isometric moves, we're going to focus now on more side lines or side crunches, okay? But first, we're going to take your left leg, hands on hips, step out and in, out and in. Keep it out, watch.
Just a little bit more. Let's add the pulse.
triple pulse. 3, 2, 1. Bend, extend. 3, 2, 1. Bend, extend. Let's go. Pop, pop, pop. And if you want more with your arms, add it on. Remember, we don't sink our elbows. It stays lifted to work your stabilizing muscles. Pop, pop, pop. Hold it here. Front, back. Nice and easy. Catching your breath. Giving the muscles a release. 3, 2, 1. Hold it here. Just find your rhythm. Find your rhythm. Pulse it through the back. And you just want to adjust your hips to keep it square. Sweat is dripping. Now, if you want more, add your arms. So, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Three more times. Come on, pump, pump, pump. 36 feet to the back. Down you go.
Like
Bend the knees, walk the feet closer, and then slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. All right, so hopefully that will help you for the second half of class, which in we face the bar, and we're gonna do a lot of Pilates or mat work for today, okay? So as we face the bar, I'm probably gonna be turning to you so you can see how my legs look. But feel free to just focus and face the bar. So you're gonna take both hands, face the bar, all right? Roll the shoulders up, back, and down. Now watch. My heels are gonna be together. My legs are gonna be inside of them. I'm holding the bar, I pulse it down. Pulse, pulse, all right? This is your 3-8 pulse. All right, roll the shoulders up, back, and down. Keep the hips square. You tuck that tailbone in. Right here. Hold. Down for two. Here we go. Down. Two. Up. Two. And stretch. Down. Two. Up. Two. And stretch. Down. Two. Up. Two. And stretch. Single. Down and up. Down and up. Nice and easy. Alright, I call this the Elvis. Watch my knees, I'm going to close it in. In, in. You grew up with this, where you had that ring or the adductor machine. This is it. This is the workout for your inner thighs. Alright? If you have that ball, imagine you have this ball. Squeeze and pump, squeeze and pump. Come on. Remember in the beginning of the workout, I made you push your knees out. Now, your tempo is in, in. Oh! Slow it down. In and out. In and out. How are those inner thighs? Minds are burning. So the next music comes, okay? Last 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, stretch it open, stretch it open. Bring the feet together. This time, your feet are gonna be parallel, okay? Bend the knees. You're gonna step back. Back, cha-cha, let's go, back, back. Now you can do this with your heels lifted or down. Four, three, two, one, hold. Stay down here, bring the heels down. Now feet can be parallel or they can open up to your diamond. My knees are bent, okay? They're kind of turned out, but that'll all depend on your hip mobility. So if your knees are slightly in, that's okay. What I don't want you to do is to open up to me. You want to make sure your shoulders are right square onto that chair, okay? Hips are square. All right, I'm gonna keep my leg out. Watch my knees. They round out to the outside elbow. So if I show you my profile, my knees make a round, okay? And if that's too much for the hips, they can go in here. your leg is soft, not straight. Two, one. Bring that leg down. Standing leg crosses over. Let's switch sides. This time, your other leg, or your back leg. Bring it behind you. We're gonna kick it back. So turning out the hips, fell all the pin, our beautiful and unique bodies. All right? What you want to focus on is really how can you squeeze your glutes a little bit more, okay? Use the glutes and the muscles under your butt to lift the leg up without arching your back. No arching of the back. Hold it up. Bring the knees to the elbow. Knee to elbow. If you can round out your hips, go for it. Four. Keep going. Now if you notice, it's a standing leg that's burning. Ah, because that's a leg that's stabilizing your entire body. Four. Three. Two. One. Hold it out. Flex the feet. Frog kicks out to the back. Remember, no arching of the back. Core engaged. Four. Three. Two. One. Bring that leg down. Oh, you're standing leg. Cross it over. Figure four. Glute stretch. When you're ready to do so, okay? Alright. So, your mat work. I know I made you sit on your hips, but I'm remembering my Corey. You're actually going to be in tabletop position. So I'll give you some time to go on tabletop. So as we go on tabletop position, your shoulders are in line with your wrists. Want more support for your abs or for your body, you bring the knees out wider, okay? Now here's what you don't want to do. You don't want your arms to be over here. That's going to cause a lot of injury. Directly under your shoulders, okay? Knees under your hips, core engaged, nice neutral spine where you can balance a teacup. All right, we're going to lift the knees off the mat. So curl your toes, lift and drop. Lift and drop. Now the lift doesn't have to be very high. It's really all about integrating your core, pressing the palm down to the mat, and lifting up, okay? Just an inch off. Warming up the abs. Four. Hold it up. We're gonna walk the feet. We go out, out, in, in. Out to plank. And if this is too much off the mat, you can be on the mat. A little bit faster. Out, out, in, in. Out, out, in, in. Or you can stay the tempo that's comfortable for you. Hold it in. Bring it down. All right. Extend your front leg. You're going to pulse it in three times. Ready? Let's go. Three, two, one, out. Keep going on the same side. Now you can do this on your knees or your toes. Four more. Last one. Try it on the other side. Knee in. And again, if you want to challenge yourself on your toes, you can. Just keep the hips square, long spine. This not only works your core, but your shoulders as well. Tucking the tailbone in as the knee drives into the elbow. Couple more here. Last one, last one.
Squeeze the butt. All right, keep the heels together.
yourself up. Head switch sides. Big inhale. Stretch out your glutes. Roll yourself up. Feet come outside, lift your hips. Exhale here. You can bend the knees and grab where it's comfortable. Just one last stretch for your lower back. Slowly roll up. All right. Thank you for joining us today at the YMCA of Delaware members page. This is Mel from Dover YMCA.